How are we doing, folks? Indeed. Right, so yes, I'm getting through these videos at the moment, so... Oh, messes there. Yeah. So what vlogging camera would I recommend? I've used this as a vlogging camera. This is a Sony X3000. This has got optical stabilizer in it. I'm watching the screen there, folks, if anyone gets angry about that. It's because I'm lining the shot up, you see what I mean? And yes, it doesn't have an LDC screen, anything like that. It's that's it. So you can vlog like that because it's so wide that you're going to be in the image if you like that. It's not too bad. But again, you don't know what you're recording, and that's for me. I like to line shots up, keep the horizon line level and all that jazz, folks. So. You know, if you're just doing a quick point and shoot, quickly, or sneaky, get some sneaky shots there, folks. Make sure no one can see. That is a good camera to use. I've used the GoPros for a vlogging camera at one point. I've done a video once in Dover because it was raining. I didn't want to go out with the other camera. It's raining. And, yeah, it was just like the audio and the hand movements. Nah. This is a good vlogging camera, this one here. You know, it's a bit heavy on the old hands, but you can do that. No, I'm only joking. This is an old classic Sony FX1. Good camera, but it's tape. My best vlogging camera, I can tell you. And this is from years of use of this camera that I've got right here. The focus is spot on, the quality is spot on, the sound is spot on, no external microphone for this one, folks, and it's simple to use. You know, I recently bought the Sony A7S II. It's an amazing camera for shots, static shots, b-roll shots and stuff like that. Always going to be using this camera for that. This is an amazing camera, low light conditions, amazing. A7S II, you've got the mufflers on there, and you can use it. I'm going to get a thing for it, and you're going to. This is basic for underground work now. I'm going to be using this camera, folks. Amazing, full frame, and all that stuff. But is this a vlogging camera? No. I've used this camera to do some vlogs. I've ruined some shots, like that. It's got no flip-out screen. If you want to use them, I don't use them. I always like to know what I'm filming that way. I'm not really bothered about that. Because with that camera here that I'm going to show you in a minute, doesn't matter. With this, it does matter. Because the focus, the face recognition on this camera is shocking. Sadly. I think Sony should have took the Canon one, put it in there. But this, the quality on this camera is super amazing. I can't stress that enough. Nighttime mode, the ISO goes up to 406,000 ISO or something like that on this. And it's great, but this is not a vlogging camera, folks. This is for professional use, I'd say, end of the day. Because I've lost quite a bit of footage. I've been filming myself, can't see what it's filming, and it's been focused on the background, and it's hadn't noticed it, folks. What other cameras have I used for vlogging? I've used the Canon 70D. I've used that. That's a good one. The only trouble is I like filming in 60 frames a second, 1080p. And that only does 30 frames a second, so it's not really that good for that. But it's a good camera still. So this camera here, I use that. Proper people use that. It's good. It's handy. This is a 77D. Hasn't got it on there because I've got the micro muff on there. This is a Canon 77D, and this is the best. This is a 10-18mm lens. This is the best vlogging camera you can buy. You don't need an external microphone. I've tried that. I've got the Rode VideoMic Pro. It's shockingly rubbish. I can't get on with it. It's too much rumble. There's too much wind noise and stuff like that. The dead cats you get don't get rid of the wind. It makes it a little bit more bearable. But you need, if you want one of the wind jammers, the big ones, you get the TV ones, the big boxing around it, like a. Done. It's like on a pole, isn't it? And they're aiming it around, and it's got, you can put fur on that as well. They're good. I've used them before. but they're a bit expensive and it's not good for vlogging, is it? So yes, it's a light camera, it's light. This is, you know, it's touch screen as well. SD card, it's not micro SD, it's just normal. I've got this battery thing on it, so we can put two more batteries into it like that. The focus on this camera, it focuses on your face every time, so you don't have to worry about doing that, filming yourself, because you know it's focused on you. With the Sony, it doesn't do that. It just it focuses on what it wants. Say if you're like that, filming, you've got to constantly look at that to make sure that, not on this camera, I mean on the Sony, you've got to constantly look at the lens like that to make sure it's going to pick your face up. When you look away, it goes off and it focuses on the background. With the Sony, that is. With this one, the Canon 77D, it doesn't do that. It tracks your face if you do that or whatever you do. Absolutely crazy. The face recognition on the Canons, absolutely crazy. What else can we say about this? Audio is smashing. Audio is crisp. You need some micro muffs on it like that, and you are laughing, folks. Yeah, I've had no problems with this. I ain't got the SD card in it, but it goes in there. This is the best, all-time best vlogging camera you can get, I'd say. Yeah. There's so many others. I've tried it, folks. I've been there. I've tried them. That's nothing wrong with that. It's just you can't see. And the audio is a bit weird. Again, like the GoPros, it's a bit... You can hear that too much. So it's a bit temperamental. With this, it's boom. You know, so we've got loads of explorers on this camera. Like the big the weapon storage area places and stuff like that. And the airfield hangars. Wow. Yeah. This is the vlogger, folks, and I can't wait to get back out in the shocking times of the coronavirus. I can't wait to get back out and do some more vlogging. I'm going to have to do it at some point. I have to sneak out, aren't I? And keep away from people, because we don't want to start all that stuff. But yes, if you can get this cheap on eBay or something like that, folks, invest in it. Invest indeed. The 77D. Yeah, so thanks very much for watching, folks. I hope you enjoyed that. I hope that's, from years of experience. This comes down to, it's not sort of like, I've not been doing it for like a few months. I've been doing this years, and I know what a good camera is, folks. The 77D is a smashing camera. If you can't afford that, that is not as expensive, but it's still an expensive camera. That's about £250, something like that, this one, around that jazz. Type it in, folks. I'll put some links in the description, folks, if you want to check it out. If you're not interested in vlogging, then the Sony's A7S cameras gonna be good for you. But yeah, thanks very much for watching, Joe. Folks, check out Instagram, Facebook and all that jazz. Check out the channel, exploring videos. It's what we do. This is what ICS is all about. And yeah, it's all smashing stuff at the end of the day. So thank you, folks, and I'll see you later. Cheers.